This video tutorial, I will explain what is web services. Web service is a way for two applications or two electronic devices to communicate over the network. There is a possibility both the applications are developed using Java. And there is a possibility one application is developed using Java, another application is developed using .NET. Even though using web services, both applications can communicate with each other. Web service uses interoperable format to transfer data between the application. Interoperable format is nothing but XML or JSON, which is a common format between these two applications. Here you can see two people, Ram and Arun. Ram speaks Tamil and Arun speaks Telugu. For them to communicate effectively, they need a common language like English, common grammar rules, and medium like speaking or writing. And here you can see application 1, which is written in Java, and application 2, which is written in .NET. Even though they are built in different programming languages, they need to communicate. Just like Ram and Arun use common language to talk, application 1 and application 2 use common formats like XML, JSON, CSV, or text files to exchange information. They also use protocols like HTTP, SMTP, or FTP to send and receive data. The communication happens over networks, such as LAN or the internet. So web services allow different applications to communicate with each other, even if they are built using different technologies, by using the common formats and protocols. Just like people with different native languages can communicate using a common language. In web service, there will be two actors, provider and consumer. Provider is the application that offers a service. Here you can see .NET application. It provides some information or functionality, like giving current weather or processing a payment. Consumer is the application that uses the service provided by the provider. And here you can see Java application. It asks provider for information or to perform certain task. Now we will see how it works. The consumer sends a request to the provider. The provider processes the request and sends back the response with the required information or confirmation that the task is done. For example, imagine you have an app on your phone which acts as a consumer that checks the weather. When you open the app, it sends the request to the weather service, which is nothing but provider. The service then sends back the weather information to your app. This is how the web services work. One application provides a service and another service uses the service. In case of web application, the client will send HTTP request through web browser. In case of web service, the client will send HTTP request through application like Android app or iOS app or from another application. There are two types of web services are there. First one is SOAP, which is nothing but Simple Object Access Protocol. The second one is REST, which is nothing but Representational State Transfer. SOAP is a protocol that defines a set of rules for sending structured information over the internet. SOAP uses XML to format the data. Here you can see the information about employees like ID, name, designation and department is written in XML format. A message in SOAP looks like a letter written with specific rules to ensure everyone understands it. Next we will see REST. REST is a set of rules that allows different applications to communicate using simple HTTP request. REST often uses JSON, which is a lightweight data format that is easy for humans to read and machines to parse. Here you can see the same employee information written in JSON format. A message in REST is like a simple note passed between the applications, easy to read and understand. When you compare SOAP and REST, SOAP is more rigid and follows strict rules, which is good for security, but it can be complex. REST is more flexible and easier to use, making it popular for modern web services. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click on like button and please subscribe to my channel. You can get Java source code and PowerPoint presentation for each and every video. That you can see it in the description section of the video. Click on show more and here you can see the description and here you can see the links to download source code and PowerPoint presentation.